الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. Today Allah help us to recite some verses from Surah Yasin. I know some culture make Surah Yasin the best surah, and some culture some culture only focus in Holy Quran, only Surah Yasin. Surah Yasin is great surah. Okay, you must believe that the great surah, but not the best surah in Holy Quran. The best surah in Holy Quran, Surah Al-Fatiha. Actually, all ahadith talk about Surah Yasin. All ahadith is very, very weak ahadith, except one hadith. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Iqra'u 'ala mawtakum Surah Yasin." When last moment in anyone die, recite some verse from Surah Yasin. Okay, I remember like last year, one sister called me, said, "Please, my father in hospital. Now stay 3 months in hospital. The soul can't go out. Can you go help him?" I said, "May Allah help all of us." So I went, recite the first part of Yasin. Then I moved to "Inna ashab al jannati al yawma fi shughlin fakihun." Because in the last moment you feel everything. I recite some ayat about paradise in Surah Yasin. And alhamdulillah, the man, alhamdulillah, passed away. And may Allah accept him. And his daughter very happy, said, "Wow, what you did?" I said, "Only I would recite some verse from Surah Yasin." As our Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam taught us. But today I'm emphasizing about Yasin. Number one is not the name of Prophet Muhammad. It's not the name. Number two, was Quran al-Hakim. The Quran is the wise book. What I emphasize about is the Ashab al-Qari. Village as Santa Clara here, or town as Santa Clara. Imagine village in the past, Allah sent me 2 messengers. And all people reject. Said, "No, you are liar. You are human like us. Go away." Okay. And Allah supported number 3 messenger. And all people said, "No, you are human like us. If you talk again, we will kill you or are stoning you." And 3rd messenger. Imagine the people. Same history repeated itself. For Allah revealed this surah to Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, saying, "Oh Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, don't be sad. Quraysh will attack you. Quraysh, they will try to kill you. Quraysh will say, 'Okay, you are human as us. Why you talk? Why you want to be as very significant man? Why?'" People also attack three messengers. They deny them. Imagine, and one man came from same city, same color, same culture, said, "وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ." Wow, one from them, same language. Okay, now we reject 3 messengers. One, okay. 4 of them, they are very good people. They not ask you any money. 4 of them. They call you to pray to La ilaha illallah, good manners. What they did with him, they killed him. When he passed away, he saw him in paradise, saw his self. And he make down, imagine when he saw his bliss in paradise, he didn't say, "Oh, my people, very bad people." And insult his people, say, "Ya layta qawmi ya'lamun bima ghafara li rabbi wa ja'alani min al-mukarramin." Said, "Oh, I wish my people, they knew Allah forgive my sins." Did you understand? He looked to his sins. Don't look to your good deeds. If you are good believers, always look to your sins. Bad people look to what? To his, "I'm not to my hasanat." But we must learn from him. Actually, he's a very humble man. His name is, he's a carpenter. Habib al-Najjar, okay? Very humble man. And he said some word, be Quran, and must repeat it. "Ya layta qawmi ya'lamun bima ghafara li rabbi." Allah forgive my sins. You must say, "Oh, Allah forgive my sins." Don't focus about the sins people around you. Think, "Oh, this guy bad, this lady is bad, I'm good." If you say that, you are very bad. Because you follow shaitan way. But if you follow Allah way, follow prophet's way, follow righteous way, say, "Bima ghafra li rabbi وَجَعَلَنِي مِنَ الْمُكْرَمِينَ. But if Allah forgive our sins, if Allah put us in paradise, Allah honor us. But the grace from Allah, the mercy of Allah. But our action is very bad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clean our heart.
Amen.
Make our heart clean to understand the Quran, to follow Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. It's raining outside. The best time to make dua. And when it's raining, some of our youth take the car and they play outside, and unfortunately he passed away last night. His age 22. I don't want to mention his name, because his father now has calamity way 2 hours ago. It's not from our Santa Clara. Okay, he played when raining outside. When I play like what's his name, Donut. They want to play with the cars. Happy car accident. Damage in his head and his neck, and he passed away last night. Last night, his father and his mother has horrible life because only has one son. Oh, he's 22 years old. So imagine, 22 years old, they spent the money, support him, he passed away because what? He's careless. He play in raining outside. We must teach our kids, our youth, ring outside, sit down and calm down, make dua. Imagine any father see his son pass away in front of him. It's not easy. So father or mother, may Allah and he give them good patience. And if he said, take care if you drive your car, it's not means we are crowned. We are, everyone will die. Who wants to believe that? Everyone will die. In raining, in masjid. But take care. Don't make something, and may Allah protect us from act as shaitan way. Okay. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. May Allah give his parents patience. Exactly.